Welcome back, students. In the previous class, we have completed a topic, Introduction to Cellular Mobile System, Uniqueness of Mobile Radio Environment, Operation of Cellular Systems, next, Consideration of Components of Cellular System. So, in this class, we will discuss about hexagonal shaped cells, N-log-N digital cellular system, and evolution. We will complete these three topics today. Okay, hexagonal shapes, N-log-N digital cellular system, third one, evolution of cellular system. Let's go into the topic. First one, hexagonal shapes or hexagonal shaped cells. In cellular mobile communication and cellular communication, why it is named as cellular communication? Here, in order to communicate wirelessly, we are dividing the geographical area into some cells. So, what is the shape of the cell? Why we are preferring only the hexagonal shaped cell? There are two reasons. One is, there exists no overlapping in hexagonal shaped cells. Second one, there are no gaps between the cells. Okay, so the hexagonal shapes are properly fit into the planned area with no gap and no overlap between the cells. If you take a circle, if you take a cellular circle, see, there exist some gaps here. There is some gaps. If you want to cover these gaps, the cells may overlap. Overlapping of cells causes interference because this cell has some frequency, this cell has some frequency, and this cell has some frequency. And there exists interference among these cells. So, in order to, if there are no interference, there is some gap. And this gap, if there any mobile user exists in that gap, he will get no signal. The coverage will be nothing because we will communicate, we will transmit depend upon the cell area. Okay. If you want to cover these gaps, the cells will get overlap, then interference will occur. Okay. Interference will occur. If you take triangle, there exists no overlapping. Okay. If you take triangle, there exists no overlapping. But the area of triangle is very less. If you take square, here also there is no possibility of overlapping of cells. Okay? Overlapping may not occur, but the area of square is very less. So compared to, by discussing all these things, circle, triangle, square, we are preferring only hexagon. Why? Because in hexagon, there exists no overlapping, of cells, first one. Second one, why I am preferring hexagon means, the area of hexagon is very efficient, okay? Means, by comparing all these cells, it is 83% or 81% efficient compared to the area of the others. And the other parameter is, with respect to area, one is area, with respect to area of hexagon is efficient with respect to square, triangle, circle. Of course, we are not preferring circle because there exist some gaps, and if there are no gaps, there will be some interference among these cells. By considering all these things, we are preferring the cell shape as hexagon. So, the hexagonal shapes are properly fitted to the planned area with no gap and no overlap. These two points are important. No gap and no overlap. That is the first one. The last one is, there is no gap in triangle, no gap in square. Then why hexagon? Because the area of hexagon is more compared to square and triangle. These are the three main points in order to choose the shape as hexagonal shape for the cellular communication. Second point, the cellular system which depends on the hexagons is made implementable either by a simple mechanism or by a statistical approach. See, there exist n number of approaches. Okay, by using manual approach, simple mechanism, we will go through the mechanism. This is a statement. We will go through n number of mechanisms, n number of statistical approach. How we will plan the hexagonal shape with respect to, there exist different areas. There will be some hilly area, flat area, okay, irregular geographical areas exist. Okay, there will be some forest area with very tall trees. So we will discuss in this subject n number of approaches, n number of models. So, as already discussed, go to this figure. Okay, hexagonal shape, ideal approach, or the real approach. So, why we are choosing the hexagonal shape? Okay, that is with respect to topic hexagonal shape itself. The topic describes about why we are choosing hexagonal shape itself. That's it. Okay, second topic, n log n digital cellular system. Analog in digital cellular system. So here we will discuss what are the techniques used in analog communication or analog cellular system, not analog communication, sorry. Analog cellular system and digital cellular system. Already where the analog digital system or analog cellular system first used, where it is used, what are the techniques implemented, and where we have used the digital cellular system, what are the techniques used, where it is implemented, there is an example or not. We will discuss these things only. Okay. So a cellular telephone system can be analog or digital. Older cellular system means, older cellular system is analog system. Now the cellular system is digital. Okay, first the cellular system is analog system. Analog cellular system. So what are the techniques used? AMPS. Okay, AMPS techniques, TACS, NMT, okay, Advanced Mobile Phone System, AMPS, TACS for Total Access Communication System. You have to remember these abbreviations, because while discussing analog cellular system, we have to mention these techniques. What are the techniques used in analog cellular system? This NMT, Nordic Mobile Telephone. Okay, similarly, the newer systems are digital. Newer systems are digital, which are GSM. Okay. One is the GSM, CDMA, code division multiple access, PCS. PCS stands for personal communication system. GSM stands for global system for mobile. These are the analog techniques. AMPS, TACS, NMT. These are digital techniques. See, we will discuss what are the analog techniques, analog cellular techniques. Digital cellular techniques, where it is used, okay, how they have implemented, in what year they have implemented, what are the benefits of using digital cellular compared to analog cellular. We will discuss these topics only. So what is the difference? The major difference between the two systems is how the voice signal, okay, by establishing the cellular system, what we are doing, we are communicating. So, how the voice signal is transmitted between the phone and the base station. Okay, between your mobile phone to the base station, how it is transmitted. With analog system, the audio is directly modulated to your carrier. So, what is happening in analog system? In analog system, audio is directly modulated to your carrier. You know, I have studied previously in your second year, okay, about analog communication, modulation. What is a carrier? What is a message signal? So, no need to mention particularly what is mean by a carrier, what is mean by modulation. So, which is like FM only, where the audio signal is translated to the radio frequency signal. So there is a thing happening in analog cellular system. So what is happening in digital? In digital systems, the audio is converted to sample. You know what is meant by sample? Sampling. In digital communication, I have studied. Okay. So what is the use of sampling? So by using the samples, we are transmitting the audio. Okay, the voice signal. Here we are going to modulation with respect to carrier. Here we are converting it into samples. So with analog transmissions, interference gets translated directly to the recovered signal, and there is no check that received signal is authentic. See, means there is no security in analog communication. There is no guarantee that the transmitted signal will reach the destination. There may be a lot of interference in analog cellular system. So the neat thing about the digital, so what is the advantage in digital? The neat thing about digital is that is ones, okay, and zeros, okay, ones and zeros cannot be easily confused or distorted. You know, the digital communication is more secure with respect to analog. The same points are mentioned here. Can be easily confused or distorted during transmission. Plus, extra data is typically included in the transmission to help detect and correct any errors. Means, by using some Hamming code, okay, by using some Hamming code techniques, we can secure the data. Okay. So here, analog communication interference gets translated. Means interference exists. It is not guaranteed that the transmitted signal, that the voice signal, reach the destination. Here it is guaranteed, because here cannot easily confuse or manipulate the zeros and ones. If it is manipulated, we have some error correction codes, error detection codes, in order to make it clear. This is about digital cellular. Next, those are the concepts. Okay, previously I discussed how analog signal is transmitted, how the digital signal is transmitted. Okay, whether it is secured or not, okay, which is better, whether analog communication, analog cellular system or digital cellular system. Now we are discussing about the analog systems previously exist. For example, in analog cellular system, we are discussing about cellular systems in the United States. Okay, cellular systems in the United States, what they have used. Okay, in those years, okay, how they have established the analog communication in the respective area. Okay. Here we are discussing about the cellular system in the United States. Similarly, we will discuss about cellular system analog communication or analog cellular system in Japan. Later we will discuss about same with respect to digital cellular system also. See, these are the examples. Here we have studied what is analog cellular system, what is digital cellular system, techniques used in analog and digital cellular system. Next, how they are transmitted with respect to modulation, and here with respect to sampling, samples. Next, we are discussing about the security. Here manipulation is difficult in digital. Here it is not guaranteed in analog cellular system. Now we are discussing the analog cellular system in respect to area. So these example are taken as a model. 150 major market areas in the United States where licenses for cellular systems can be granted by FCC. Means there, the FCC means Federal Communication Commission used to give the permissions for the cellular system establishment. So in that time, there are 150 major market areas in the United States. Okay, so they have differentiate like this into 5 groups. Okay, so each group has 50 cities. See, here in order to establish communication there, we have to select the geographical area. Okay, so here they have selected some 150 market areas. In those they have differentiated like this: top 30 markets, 31 to 60, 61 to 90, 91 to 120, 121 to 150. Okay, but very large large, medium, below medium, small cells. So with respect to the population, with respect to the need of coverage, they are going to establish the cellular system. This is just an example. Okay. So this is just the process, how the analog system, not establish analog cellular system, how we used to analyze. They are differentiated into some market areas. So with respect to some population or with respect to the area, okay, where the coverage is required, they are differentiated like this and established the analog communication, analog cellular communication there. And cellular system outside the United States. So here NTT is there, Nippon Telegraph and Telephone Corporation developed a 800 MHz land mobile telephone system and put into service in Tokyo area in 1979. Okay, the general system operation is similar to AMPS system. AMPS, Advanced Mobile Phone System. Generally, here AMPS is used. But here, the analysis is there, the techniques are not mentioned and not described. Here, in NTT, we are describing the frequency. Okay. And here the technique used is with respect to which is similar to AMPS system. This is the figure. Okay. This is the Japanese mobile telephone service network configuration. Here there exists some end office. This is just for analysis. Okay, just for analysis. See, we have studied about analog cellular system, digital cellular system, and we are describing where the analog system is previously used in the United States. Outside the United States, in Japan we have used. What is the technique they are using? How it is planned? How they have differentiated? How they have established? So there is an end office, okay. There is a TC, there is a toll center. Next, there is a district center. And there is a regional center. Okay. They are differentiated. Okay. Like there is a district. There is a mandal. There are some villages like that. Here also, there is an end office. There is a toll center. There is a district center. There is a regional center. There it will connect it to AMC. This is a switching center, like telephone exchange. Okay. Automobile switching center. Okay. There is an MCS, mobile control station. Okay, and there is an MBS, mobile base station. Okay, and there are MSS. Okay, subscriber. The subscriber is moving, means we only. Okay, MSS, mobile subscriber station. So with respect to mobile subscriber station, there is an end office. We are communicating through this setup. Right. So this is the configuration followed by Japan. Next, a digital cellular system. Similar, we have discussed about the analog system in United States and Japan. Like that only, we are discussing about digital cellular system. Okay, in 1992, the first digital cellular system was deployed in Germany. There, GSM they have used, which is a European standard. Next, in the United States, we have they have used NATDMA system, okay, which is mentioned as IS-54. In CDMA system, mentioned as IS-95, been developed there in the United States. Okay. Next, NATDMA was developed in 19. These are all the, here we are discussing about the techniques. These are the digital techniques. Okay. NA means North American. North American time division multiple axis was developed in 1993. CDMA, CDMA means code division multiple axis. Okay, planned for deployment in 1995. And the Japanese system is PDC, Personal Digital Cellular, was deployed in Osaka in June 1994. See, these are all the digital systems. These are all the digital cellular systems. Okay, in different countries, in which year they have developed, and which technique they have used. That's it. Next. This is about the topic. This is about the topic with respect to analog and digital cellular system. I completed two topics till now. One is with respect to hexagonal shaped cells. Second one with respect to enlargement distal cellular systems. Next, let's go to the topic, third topic in this class, which is evolution of cellular system. How the cellular system is evolved. Okay. So, we used to say it as a generation. Okay. There is a 1G, first generation, 2G, second generation, 3G, third generation, 4G, fourth generation, 5G, fifth generation. Of course, now we are already using 4G communication. Okay. And already 5G is established in some countries, very few countries. Maybe in 2 or 3 years, India will also get 5G communication. Anyway, let's discuss these things. 1G technology. In 1G technology or 1G wireless technology or 1G first generation cellular communication, first generation cellular system, anyway you can call it 1G wireless technology, first generation cellular system, or 1G mobile communication, or 1G mobile system. Okay. Technique used is AMPS, okay, elevated Bell Labs, installed in 1982. Okay. Here the analog signals is used, the speed is 2.4. These are, see, whatever the points I am mentioning, these are the important points to remember. And you have to elaborate by listening these points. Technique used, which is developed, where it is developed, when it is deployed, what is the speed, what is the frequency used, 150 MHz. Okay, so what are the drawbacks? Okay, we have a very large mobile set will be there, which has a poor battery. And since it is using an analog cellular system, very poor voice quality. And the mobile phone size is very large. And it, since it is an analog communication, it is not guaranteed. Okay, voice signal may reach destination. So, no security. And there is a frequency call drop. No handoff mechanism. Okay, no handoff mechanism. Frequency call drop means when you are entering from one cell area to other cell area, the call will drop and you have to reconnect again. Okay, if the call is not dropped and the same call is forwarded, okay, which is taken care about the other cell area which you are going to move, that is called handoff. In analog cellular system, handoff is not present. That's why the call drop exists. Okay. Next, 2G or second generation. Okay, here there is a large support to, or there exist some services like text messages, picture messages, you can send the picture, you can text, you can use some multimedia services, MMS, and better quality compared to 1G, and is widely used in from 90s to 2000, year 2000, or in 2020, then we have, after 2000, we have used the 2G, and it allows multiple users in single channel, supports voice as well as data. Okay. Next, if the technologies are TDMA and CDMA, are used two technologies for multiplexing techniques. Speed is 9.6. Previously it is 2.4 kbps. Now it is 9.6. The carrier frequency is 200 kHz. So what are the drawbacks then? Drawback is the digital signal is somewhat weak, and the systems are unable to handle complex data such as videos. So, the data support exists, but it is very complex to load the videos. Then the 2.5G, okay. Here the main part is about GPRS. Difference between 2G and 2.5 is, here we are using the service called, technology called GPRS, General Packet Radio Service, okay. So, here by using this technique, there are some advantages, we will discuss these things. Anyway, we will discuss about the features here. It is described as 2G, and usually from 2001 to 2004. In addition to circuit switched data, packet switched data, means packet, the general packet radio service. Previously, we have used a circuit switching, now using packet switching. And we have a better streaming video,
and supports web browsing.
Okay.
Here, G stands for General Packet Radio Service here.
Okay.
And there are n number of services here. Okay. We're using some WAP service, a wireless application protocol services. You can browse. Okay. There are, you can some browse. And previously there is some Java mobiles. And based upon the apps, you can browse some data in the internet.
Okay.
And we have some MMS services, multimedia services. And but the carrier frequency is same as with respect to 2G. And internet support increases. Email support is there. Okay. And we can access the web too. Features, phone calls. Okay. Good clarity of voice signals exist. And we can send or receive the email messages. Web browsing exists. Speed increased from 9.6 kbps to here 9.6 kbps in the 2G communication. In 2.5G, speed is 64 to 144 kbps, and it supports the camera phones. Okay, it supports the camera phones. Next, 3G. Okay, 3G technologies. Okay, 3G technology means it is maybe some UMTS technology. Or some HSPA technology. There exist two types of technologies in 3G, and the speed increases from 144 to 2 Mbps. Okay, provides faster communication.
Okay,
and good support with respect to email messages. Security has been increased. We can stream videos. We can stream TV. We can stream some mobile TV.
Okay,
next, the carrier frequency is not in kilohertz. It is in megahertz. See, what are the points mentioning, you have to remember these things, okay, which are very important. Next, as mentioned, they offer great security and they have taken many measures while communicating from one device to other device.
Okay.
And these are the communication we have already discussed, like mobile TV, video on demand, and we can conference calls exist.
Okay.
Video conferencing exists. You can make a video call to in a 3G communication. Video call support first came into existence in 3G technology only.
Okay.
And it will support GPS.
Okay.
Through internet, you can travel from one place to other place where which you don't know the destination by using some GPS technology, which is interconnected to the antenna.
Okay.
You can go from one place to other place. Next, drawbacks is spectrum requirement. Okay, high bandwidth is required. Next, in order to use a 3G, because if a video call exists, we need some expensive mobile phones, not a basic mobile phone. We need some expensive mobile phones and large cell phones with a good display are needed. Next, 4G. Okay, now we are using the 4G system only. The speed is 100 Mbps to 1 Gbps. More secure, high capacity.
Okay,
the cost per bit is very less for transmission. And it improves the capacity, coverage, and secures, and which is very friendly with respect to user. And these are some of the features. The standard use, this is important. Standard use is LTE.
Okay,
LTE for long term evolution. And VoLTE with VoiceOver, okay, VoiceOver, long-term evolution, VoLTE support is there. And supports at a time 200 active clients, okay, for every 5 MHz cell. So technologies we have used is edge means 3.5, okay, sorry, 2.75. There is edge means, here there is a generation called 2.75, 2G, GSM, 2.5G, GPRS. 2.75G edge technology.
Okay.
And if it is an UMTS or HSPA, UMTS or HSPA, it is 3G or 3.5G.
Okay.
So UMTS means 3G, HSPA means 3.5G. Means in 3G technology, we are using the technique UMTS, 3.5G, we are using the technique HSPA. Edge stands for enhanced data rates for GSM communication, means the same features exist as 2.5G, but in 2.75G
using the edge technology for increasing of this data rate, speed.
That's UMTS, Universal Mobile Telecommunication System, HSPA, High Speed Packet Access. These are the abbreviations. Next. And it also provides multicast broadcast single frequency network support.
Okay.
Because for fast moving, if the user is in mobility, okay, then it will be very goodful, very helpful for the user in order to establish a good internet. Drawbacks are the battery usage is more because the features are more.
Okay.
The battery usage will be more. Somewhat hard to implement.
Okay.
We need a good hardware and we need a very expensive mobile phone for the 4G.
Okay.
Next, 5G technology.
Okay.
10 times faster than 4G.
Okay.
And speed is of 1 Gbps. Okay. 1 Gbps, not Mbps, Gbps. And very cheaper with respect to previous version, and features are with respect to the uploading and downloading speeds are up to 1 Gbps.
Okay.
And it will be supported wireless world wide web, not world wide web, wireless world wide web. Means not establish a smart city, not to develop a smart city, the communication need is a 5G communication.
Okay.
And we need a good memory, dialing speed. And the clarity of audio and video is increased drastically. And this is about 5G.
Okay.
Next, anyway, have put some differences. Means in brief, whatever we have studied now, in brief, like a table format, I have mentioned here. What are the points discussed previously are mentioned here again.
Okay.
But I highlight the generation 1G, what is the definition, what is the technique used, okay, what is the speed, what is the technology used, at what time to what time the technology exists.
Okay.
Next, what are the features of the respect to 1G, 2G, later 2.5G, GPRS, next 3G,
okay,
edge technology. So what are the features there? In a table format, I have mentioned here.
Okay.
Anyway, previous slides give a good amount of data for you not to study. And there I have mentioned each parameter in a good way.
Okay.
Here, in brief, I have mentioned what is the year they have introduced, what is the technology used, what is the speed, what is the technique.
Okay.
In a brief way, I have discussed here. Anyway, go through this reference table also.
Okay.
So, after studying this evolution of cellular system, go through this table.
Okay.
Mentions the generation, definition. Okay. What is the speed, technology use, time period, from which time to which time it exists, what are the features? 1G, 2G, 2.5G, 3G, 3.5G, 4G, and about the 5G.
Okay.
Thank you.